and Steve Hilton, and Selena Scott. Sheila Hancock, I don't want to be rude, but you're getting on a bit.
Oh, no.
I know it's a rude thing to say, but I am, yes. But the interesting thing is that the polls seem to suggest most older people are voting to leave.
Yes,
and
I
yet
know.
You're not.
Well, that surprises me. I'm 83. Probably I'm the oldest person in the room, but
no.
Being 83, well, you're...
Are you older, Nigel Lawson?
But no, seriously, what it means is that I was a child during the war, and I want to just go through the origins. I was bombed, I was evacuated, I had a horrible, horrible time, and I hated the Germans. My first husband was aircrew during the war. He was older than me, and he bombed and killed many Germans, and it haunted him for the rest of his life. My mother and father lived through two world wars that were started in Europe. The second one cost 51 million lives. Now, when I was told, and my generation were told, that we were going to unite with our enemies and try and build a better future, I rejoiced. Now, obviously, a vision like that was going to go horribly wrong. It was going to have to be worked at very hard. But now, look at the situation we're in now. The problems are global. It's not just migration, it's a shift of populations. As we had at the end of the war, there were displaced people all over the world whose homelands had been bombed to hell and were coming out of camps and looking for somewhere to live, and we solved it. There's ecological problems, environmental problems. There's huge discrepancy between the rich and the poor worldwide. And that should worry us, because that leads to extremity. Now, surely we can solve those problems better if we're united than if we close ourselves down, shut our eyes, and hate the world.
Yes.